Hi, this is Sherry. I'm back, and we are now in my suite because the video cut off again. And as you can see, I was getting fried out there, even though I was somewhat in the shade. So I don't know, maybe that's why they wanted me to bring me back here. I have no idea. But we were wrapping up the last card, and it was love. And it was talking about how important it is to express your insecurities to one another and share your feelings with one another, because this is what builds trust in your relationship. You got to be able to go to your partner, right? You don't want to be having them, expecting them to read your mind. You know, nobody, we all seem to do that at times, don't we? It's like, you know what, you should know how I'm feeling. And it's like, no, I don't know how you're feeling, so would you tell me? So you're being encouraged to express your true feelings, your innermost feelings to one another, and that's how your bond deepens. Okay, so the next card that we're getting, let's see, how will I do this? I think I'll do it like this. Labradorite, can you see it? This is a pretty stone. It's talking about telepathic communication and energy and prophecy and auras. And it's talking about that there's a situation in your life that is troubling you. And it's causing you concern, and it's preventing you from moving forward. And you're going to soon realize that it's because of fear. And once you realize that the fear is there and what it is, then you're going to look at it and you're going to move past it. And you're going to find yourself moving forward in leaps and bounds. Once I've recognized that, you know what, I was just afraid. And fear is false evidence appearing real, right? It's not even real. So once you get past this situation, I love this stone. It's kind of like an opalescent looking thing. Once you get past this, you're going to realize also at this time that you have the ability to telepathically communicate with ones. We're all interconnected. Oh, I'm so hot in here. Still, the fan's going, but it's not enough. Okay, so... telepathic communication, and I think it's interesting because the next card that we got, I'm going to just segue right into it because that's literally what it's talking about. It's selenite green. I mean, it's called selenite. It's this crystal. And it's talking about the ability to energetically communicate with ones on a soul level. And it helps you with love and healing and this type of communication. You're going to realize that you're going to be able to give and receive communication this way, even if somebody's not in front of you. We're all interconnected energetically. Past, present, future, death, life, we're all connected. We stay connected, especially to the ones we love. So you're going to learn how, on this soul level, that there is no division. And once you realize how you can connect with ones, you're going to find an ability to bring peace and tranquility into your life, because nothing is ever lost. Your connection with them is never lost. So speech starts. I encourage people all the time, if they're having issues with people and they're not in their presence, talk to them. Talk to them energetically. Talk to them from your heart, because we are energetically connected. And if you like, say, maybe sometimes people have a difficult time saying what's on their mind. So, or they've done something and they don't know how to dig themselves out, or they don't know how to apologize, or they don't know how to move forward. So say, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. But this is how I'm feeling. Because a lot of times, you know, even in relationships we were talked about just now, about how it's important to express truly how you're feeling, sometimes people have a hard time doing that. So they're saying, you can do this energetically, right? You can do this on a soul level. And the next card, I'm going to turn it this way. Look at my kitties. That one over there sleeping. This one over here sleeping. I think I'm going to have a nap too when I'm finished with this. I'm tired. This takes a lot out of me. This like literally drains me. It's a good thing, but it does. It takes a lot of energy. And it was so hot out there. I think it's just like completely zapped me. So, all right, the next card we have. Sorry, I don't know how to do this. This is horrible. Amulet stone. Ooh, there it is. I'll just do it like that. That works. Those are beautiful. These look like the stones in the bottom of there's this lake in Montana that's very, very clear, and it's got all these colored stones. I always wanted to go there. I thought that would be so cool. So an amulet stone, it's also called a thunder egg, and it talks about travel plans on the horizon. We've had a lot about that, haven't we, about travel plans? So travel plans on the horizon. There's going to be an unexpected opportunity that's going to arise, and you're going to be traveling to a faraway place. And it's interesting, I posted today about never saying no to adventure. I'm never saying no to adventure. And we've had a lot about travel. So here we all have it again, that there's going to be travel plans, and while we're away, we're going to be learning all kinds of things about our path. We're going to be learning how to bring in our physical, our spiritual, and our business and personal elements all together. Ideas and opportunities are going to arise. And we're going to find it, no doubt, you know, sincerely stimulating and exciting, because you're going to be traveling somewhere far away. Literally, they're saying far away. So you're supposed to allow you to keep it, allow yourself to keep an open mind, because I'm getting this today. I was talking to somebody else, and it's like, you know, we put self-limiting beliefs on. We do it ourselves. It's self-limiting beliefs. I don't think I can afford this. I don't think I can do this. I don't know if this is a good idea. Don't do that. That's why they're saying keep an open mind. If this is something that you want to do and you see yourself going in this direction and you can't figure out how it's going to be done, don't worry about that part. Just say to the universe, I'm going to do this. I want to do this. I'm going to have it happen. And I'm going to let you bring it to me. Whatever you need to do to bring this to me, I know that you'll figure it out. I'm just going to leave it in your hands. That's what I did with Sedona, right? I knew I was supposed to go, and I was putting it off, wasn't putting it off. And then I had this opportunity come up, and I don't know if I'm going to be going with the person that asked for me to be a guide. I've reached out to him several times and he hasn't responded. And I realized, you know what? It was just spirit's way of showing me, you know what? You need to go. You wanted to go. We've made the way open. You've got a place to stay. You're going to go do it. So that's all you have to worry about. And be this in regards to a job, be this in regards to a relationship, be this in regards to a trip or whatever it is that you are thinking about doing. They're saying go for it and don't allow ego mind to get in the way and say that you can't do this. Or someone else in your life to get in the way and say that you can't do this. Or I don't have enough money, or maybe I should be doing this, it's irresponsible. Throw all that away and just follow what your heart is saying. So that's it. That's our reading. And we got it done, and I'm going to throw it all together and post it up for you guys. It's probably 90 degrees in here. I can't get over this. I'm going to put the air on. I'm ready to go to a cooler climate, thanks. Take me to a cooler climate, universe. All right. Thank you guys for bearing with me for all the confusion. And every time I don't know why this always has to happen. I truly do need a partner that's going to help me figure this out. I put that order in, and I know that it's going to come soon. So thank you for tuning in. If you'd like to follow me, I'm on Twitter, I'm on LinkedIn, I'm on Google+, I'm on Angels Whisper, Sherry Columbus, I'm on, where am I? Sherry Columbus, Angels Whisper. I'm on YouTube, where all these videos go. If you'd like to subscribe, then you will be given a notification when the video's done. And my website, www.thewhispersofangels.com. If you'd like to have a reading done, I do dream analysis, I do personal readings, I do life coaching, I am a long distance Reiki master. So any of those things that sound appealing to you, hit me up. My email is sherwithme, sherwithme at Yahoo. So that is, when you get to the website, that's the email address that you want to deal with when you go to PayPal, and PayPal will let me know that you have contacted me, and I'll get right back to you. So I do phone readings and I do written readings. Both are advantageous for you. A phone reading is good because you get to have interaction, and I usually go way over time when I'm doing phone readings. You get a lot more time out of me, and you can ask questions that way. But a written reading is really good too, because it has something for you to look back on, and you have a hard copy. So both are really good. It just depends on what works for you. So that's it. I hope you guys have a great day. I'm going to a barbecue after I have a nap. And thank you for tuning in. I love you guys. Have a great day. Bye.